paid vacation, or paid annual leave. It's when you don't go to work and you go do whatever you want to do, like relax on a beach, and you still get paid. The United States has a big problem with it, specifically not having it. With the exception of Puerto Rico, no city or state in the United States guarantees its workers paid vacation. There's a massive disparity between the United States and other advanced economies for workers when it comes to universal paid holidays and universal paid vacation policies, as emphasized by a new report from the Center for Economic and Policy Research. In the European Union, the Working Time Directive guarantees European workers at least 20 days of paid vacation per year, with some other countries in the Union going as far up as 25 or 30 days per year. Australia and New Zealand also grant workers at least 20 days of paid vacation per year. Canada and Japan are far behind, but at least still guarantee 10 days of paid vacation days per year compared to the United States, which has zero. This disparity gets even worse when legally mandated paid holidays are taken into account. The majority of developed countries offer at least 6 paid holiday days per year, and the United States, again, offers none. The European Union in 1993 established a mandated minimum of at least 4 weeks, or rather 20 working days of paid vacation for all workers in the EU member countries, with several countries going above this limit. France has at least 30 days of paid vacation each year, the United Kingdom has 28, Austria, Denmark, Finland, Sweden, and Spain all guarantee at least 25 days each year. In addition to this, it's important to remember that these are working days, not days in general. So France's 30 days are not 1 month of paid vacation, but rather an entire 6 weeks, or a month and a half. In addition to paid vacation, many countries in the EU also have large numbers of paid holidays as well. So together with their paid vacation days, Spain offers the most, with 14 paid public holidays, followed by Austria, Germany, and Portugal, which have 13 days each. Now it's important to remember, this doesn't mean there are no paid vacations or paid holidays in the United States. A lot of workers actually do have them. But the issue is, without a federal paid vacation policy, almost 1 in 4 Americans have no paid vacations and no paid holidays. If you put together all the workers in the American private sector that get paid vacation and those who don't, on average, the American worker receives 10 days of paid vacation per year and 6 days of paid holiday per year, which is far lower than almost every other advanced economy. Furthermore, the distribution of these benefits among workers is extremely unequal. The amounts the American worker receives varies heavily based on their income and on whether or not they're part-time employed or full-time employed. Only about half of those in the lowest 25% of income get paid vacation and holidays, and among part-time workers, less than half get paid vacation and holidays. Compared to workers in the top 25% of income, and those fully employed, in which case both have over 90% of workers receiving paid vacation and paid holidays. As well, even for those lucky enough to get benefits, low-wage and part-time workers get fewer days on average than high-wage full-time workers. So in total, a bit over 3/4 of Americans received paid vacation and paid holidays, which is rather terrible compared to the 100% in most developed countries. As well, despite the fact that over 3/4 of Americans receive paid vacation and paid holidays, the fact that it's not mandated is incredibly important. This is because even if someone is actually getting paid vacation, it doesn't mean they're necessarily taking it. Workplaces are incredibly competitive, and many workers are reluctant to take time off due to work pressures, and the possibility of falling behind. They might lose out on a promotion, or even risk being fired if they take a vacation when almost no one else is. To help prevent this, some nations have taken measures to ensure vacations are being taken. Portugal, Spain, Switzerland, and the United Kingdom specifically forbid workers from offering employees extra pay in order to give up their vacation days. This can help workers from being pressured by the choice between advancement or taking time off. In the CEPR report, the average of all the advanced countries reviewed is about 22 days of paid vacation and 10 days of paid holiday, which the US, with its average of 10 days of paid vacation and 6 days of paid holiday, falls far short of. Without guarantees of minimal amounts of paid vacation, it disproportionately affects low-wage and part-time workers, who are far less likely to receive paid vacations or paid holidays. And even when they do, the amount they receive is much less than high-wage full-time workers. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video, and if you did, you can hit that like button down below, you can comment, and you can subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this one. Links are in the description down below, and I hope you guys all have a nice day.